Big weed for it.
Why shot you in that?
No, no.
What is it? Don't ever see my name.
Well, a menace. There's a guy on holiday last year. He couldn't do anything.
Yeah, it was a dead, dead wee one. Or a wee totty one. Plus a grand and a half.
Thank you. and it never stopped in that shiny little Surrey with the fringe on the top.
Look, don't do that. You wouldn't understand.
No telling what you've been up to.
Bet you say done plenty, Kansas City.
Well, I wouldn't exactly call it carrying on, but I sure did see some things I never saw before.
I got to Kansas City on a Friday. I said the first thing I told.
Now don't you say nothing again him. He's a best hard times I ever had. Just a bunch of fun by myself. Well, two women couldn't do it. You ought to know that.
You mean when I took up with a man like that?
I ain't such as took up with him.
His auntie wasn't paying in. He eats his meals like one of the family. Seems out here somewhere doing it.
And the smokehouse.
I changed my mind about leaving the head house today. Leave it till tomorrow. Got up good early. I'm driving Laurie to the party today.
You're driving what?
Ask her.
Now, wouldn't that just make you bomb? Come on, Bono. Vinny's got a date to get after that. She ain't got a nice box of lunch. The rocket.
How we going, Curly? In that rig you made up? I'll ride a straddle and their lights are winking like lightning bugs.
Back there with no makeup. You wait till here. Hand it over to Curly.
Well, that's it. But
sure thing. What do you want to do? When I come at home, I have to have something. Make sure you've got the beauty spot at 9 o'clock. No one was knocking here. Thanks, Mark.
The wheels are yellow, the upholstery's brown, the dashboard's genuine leather. With underglass curtains, you can roll right down in case of the change in the weather.
Good morning, Patty. Way back from the city.
Kind of sorry for a fella, but it looks like he wants to kiss you. When you can't
much worse if I tried to take the gaffers off.
Yeah, his enemy could stop his fall down, couldn't it?
Now get another one.
Which one? Oh, you want to buy this one to match the other one?
What do you mean I want to buy it?
I can let you have it for 50 cents, 4 pence.
Do you want me to get that egg beater and rally down your windpipe? Give me that.
All right. Don't any of you want to buy something? How about you, Miss Laurie? Must be wanting something, a pretty young girl like you.
Me? Of course I want some. Want a buckle made out of shiny silver to fasten on my shoes. Want a dress with lace. Want perfume. Want to be pretty. And smell like a honeysuckle burn.
Give it a cake of soap.
One thing's I've heard of, never had before. A rubber tire buggy. A cut glass sugar bowl. One thing's I can't tell you about, not only things to look at and hold in your hands, things to happen to you. Things so nice if they ever did happen, why your heart would quit beating and you'd just fall down dead.
I got just the thing, the elixir of Egypt.
What's that?
It's a secret formula, belong to Pharaoh's daughter.
I'm smelling salt!
But a special kind of smelling salt. Read what it says in the label. Take a deep breath and you see everything clear. That's what Pharaoh's daughter used to do when she had a hard problem to decide, like what fin she ought to marry, or what dress to wear to a party, or whether to cut off somebody's head. She'd take a whiff of this.
Pharaoh's face.
I'll take a bottle of that, Mr. Peddler.
Precious stuff.
How much?
2 bits.
Throwing your money away.
Helps you to decide what to do.
Now, don't you want me to show you some pretty doodads, you know, with lace around the bottom and ribbons running in and out?
You mean fancy drawers?
Oh, made in Paris.
Well, I never wear that kind myself, but I sure do like to look at them.
Then how about these?
These are right if you're in your place.
All right, Pillar Man, bring your captains inside. Maybe I can find you something to eat and drink.
Well, that's the why, don't you?
Ellie! Me and the Lorelei having an argument.
About what, baby?
About what you meant when you said about driving your feet into the world.
Well, I didn't really mean to the end of the world.
Then how far did you want to go?
Oh, about as far as, say, Claymore, to the hotel.
And what's the hotel?
In front of the hotel is a veranda. Inside is a lobby. Upstairs might be paradise.
I thought these are just bedrooms.
For you and me, baby, paradise.
There, you see, I'm going to write the line was wrong. It don't want to marry me, don't you?
Aedo, Annie. What did you say?
I said you don't want to marry me, don't you? What did you see?
I didn't say nothing.
Oh, now. You Aedo, Annie, is me and back.
Oh, just hello, Aedo.
You know me, old me.
That's my partner. Promise me you won't find him.
Why, I never saw the man before. I only fight with my friends.
Aedo, Annie, how's the honey bunny? How's the sweetest 110 pounds of sugar in the territory?
Well, this is Ellie Hacking.
How are you, Hack? Don't mind the way I talk, it's all right, I'm going to marry you.
Marry her? On purpose?
What sure?
That's such a thing!
It's a wonderful thing to be married.
Ellie!
I've been a brother in Persia, got 6 wives.
6 wives? Are they books?
Sure, that's the way they do it in that country.
Not always. I got another brother in Persia. Only got 1 wife. He's a bachelor.
Look well,
nothing. Know what I got for first prize at the fair? $50.
Well, that was $50?
Well, sure. Catch on. Your pa promised I could marry if I could get $50.
That's right. He did.
Know what I done with it? Spent it all friends for you.
But if you spend it, you ain't get the cash.
But what I got's worth more than cash. Carlos Omer stuff told me.
But we...
Stop saying, but will. When will I get a little kid? Gosh, ain't no any honey. You ain't been off my mind since I left. It's the fairgrounds even, when I was roping steers and rope him around to the horse and pull him up sharp and he landed his little drum. And then I think of you.
don't start talking, Purdy, Will.
See a lot of beautiful gals in Kansas City. Didn't give one a look.
How could you see him if you didn't give him a look?
I mean, I didn't look loving at him, like I look at you.
Now, don't look like that, we will. I can't bear it.
Ain't gonna stop looking this way. You give me a little kiss.
Oh, what's a little kiss?
nothing lets me come to you.
Man.
that's sad news for me. Billy is a fine fellow.
Don't have your feelings, Ailey. I can't bear it. I'd rather be cut right off and see your heart is busted too.
Are you positive you've got to marry Will?
Sure shouldn't.
And there is no chance for you to change your mind?
No chance.
All right then, my heart is busted too.
Oh, Ailey, you stupid. How pretty thing to say.
Hey, you ready?
Oh, hello, Will. Oh, what did we just talk?
Rabbits. All right, you want to hear about Will Popper getting $50?
That's right, Bob. He wasn't who you did promise.
Too bad. Still and all, I can't go back where I work. I advise you get out right now. Before you lose it all, put it in your stocking. Or inside the corset. Where it can't get at. Or can he?
But he ain't exactly Cupid. He's been it all in prisons.
See, what did I tell you? No, he can't have it. I said it had to be $50 cash.
But Mr. Campbell, it's not fair.
Who the hell are you?
This is that happy.
Well, shut your face or I'll fill you behind so fill a box shop. You've been walking around like a doctor the rest of your life.
Ailey, if I don't get to marry Will, maybe your heart don't have to be busted too, like you see.
I did not say that.
Oh, yes, you did.
No, I didn't.
Oh, yes,
hey, are you trying to make out my daughter for a liar?
No, I'm just making it clear to you what a liar I am if she is telling the truth.
What else did you say to my daughter?
Oh, not for what?
When?
Last night we were
left. Where?
I'm
listening. What else did you say?
He called me his Persian kitten.
Why'd you call her that?
I don't remember.
Oh, I do. He hit up like a Persian kitten kissing with a cat with a soft brown tail.
That's enough. In this part of the country, that better be a proposal of marriage.
That's what I thought.
Is that what you think?
Look, Mr. Cat.
I'm looking.
I'm no good. I'm a peddler. A peddler travels up and down and all around, and you can't ever see your butter no more.
Well, now, that'd be all right. You take good care of my son. You take good care of my little woman's bud.
Oh, Bob, that's pretty. You sure pretend you can bear to let me go, Bob?
Are you sure, Mr. Campbell?
Just try to change my mind.
Oh, anyway, ain't it wonderful? I'm making up his mind first, and he won't change another. Once he gives his word that you can have me, why, you got me.
I know I got you.
Mrs. Allie has you. The peddler, the bride. Oh, Will, it's up, girls!
Get up and fall, every fall. away, and I guess that you're
through. You're a mess, and blessed, and a year by head. There's a baby on your shoulder, making bubbles on your neck.
It's a scandal.
Thank you.
right? You'd rather go with me tonight?
No, I couldn't.
Oh, you couldn't? You think you're going to have to walk out tonight, don't you? See my son Elgin.
Call for water, don't you? Or let me drive the car.
5 minutes or less, you'll be dead. We're doing it.
What do you mean by that?
What's a German funeral? Sing sad song.
Yeah.
Your words, you don't know how many people like it till you did. Keep your all waiting out, your collar, your dress suit, your throne down slick, high stats cover.
Would there be any flowers, do you think?
Sure would. Hands too. Oh, why'd you come? If you had folks that gather around you. Men would bear their heads, women skip for socking. Some are glory faith and went to take a shiny when he was alive.
What woman ever took a shiny?
What's the woman? Well, you don't have to come short. Right, I'll show you how you feel worse than you died for.
I guess that's so.
We would sing loud for when the singing started. Sing like that, that's okay.
Georgia is dead. Georgia is dead.
Because Georgia is a perfect heart. Maybe you will. Maybe you'll pull the trunks.
Maybe. Let's see now. Where was it to work before you come here? Softball, was it?
Yeah, before that old bathtub, sir. Lousy they was, and me poker. Always making out they was better. Treating me like dirt.
What you do to get even?
Who said anything about getting even?
No one that I would like to just give in my head.
If it ever come to getting even with anybody, I don't know how to do it.
That?
Nah, they safer ways than that, if you use your brains. Remember that barn, the Bartlett Farm over by Sweetwater?
Sure do trouble, I said, drunk up the father of the mother and the dog.
That warn't no accident. A fellow told me, the hard hand was stuck in the Bartlett girl, and he found her in the hayloft with another fellow.
So we front the police?
Took a week to get all the kerosene, buying it at different times. Feller told me that house like it happened in Missouri, but I know all the time it was at Bartlett Farm. What a liar he was.
Yeah, I kind of can't remember if two wasn't. Yeah, where are you?
If you ain't told me what business you had here, we got no cattle to sell you, or no cow ponies. Well, the old cops don't spoke for.
Well, you should wait my life to sell it.
There's only one other thing you could want on this farm, and it better not be that.
That's just what it is.
It better not be. You keep away from her, you hear?
You know, Lolly out is a total one there than you are. For that matter, somebody will tell you what's about yourself.
You better get out of here, Curly.
Elvin's still very secret to you. You didn't know me. But I know you. In this country, there's two things you can do if you're a man. Live on George is one. Go to the home is another. Set down a horse and a bus and get a ladder sleep. Then it's go wetter, wetter, wetter. You're scared of death. And they come close to his home. Then we're going to step in. So he'll get his old hands ready for the present. Coughing away. I give him the whole you're scared. The muscles all the county still is weak to that. Well, because he got things to bother the habit. How'd you get to be the way you are anyway, sitting here in this filthy hole and thinking the way you're thinking? Why don't you do something healthy once in a while instead of crawling and fisting? Ah! You ought to do better. I don't know. You should rather show yourself. And the last one over there, about as big as a dam. See it wicked? Want to see if I can hit it?
Why, I'm having trouble right now on account of the woman. And you say you want one?
Why, look at you. You're a man who's free to come and go as you please. You've got a nice cozy place here. Private, nothing to bother me. Artistic pictures.
They don't work back.
I'm tired of all these pictures of women.
So you're tired of the pictures. You throw them away and you buy some new ones.
You get tired of a woman, what can you do? Just keep getting tired and tired.
I made up my mind.
So you want a real woman?
Say, do you happen to know a girl by the name of Ada Wani?
I don't want her.
I don't want her either, but I got her.
Don't want nothing from no peddler's bag. Want real things. What am I doing shut up in here, like that feller says, a crawling and a festering? What am I doing in this lousy smokehouse?
virgin. Must all behave herself the night my brother.
I'd like to teach you all a little sin and learn these words by heart the way I should. I don't say I'm no better than anybody else, but I'll be the head.
Say, that's a crack of tin.
Get your hands off that! That was for
our wedding night.
Don't beat you so good. I'll give you $22 for it.
What's the bet?
All right, $22.50, not a cent more. What a beautiful ankle brace.
Those is for her to wear.
I didn't have a thing for you. I'll give you $15 for it. Let's see. 8 and 22 is 30, and 15 is 45, and 50 cents is 45.50.
Say, that's almost that. Want to buy some more?
Might.
And you ever see one of these things?
What made you buy a thing like that? Got it in for something?
What do you mean? It's just for a picture.
Well, that's all you think it is.
Crazy, buddy, where's that house?
Another side of the house, sorry. Well, what do you give me for it?
I don't like to handle things like that. I guess you don't really know what it is.
Sure, do. It's just a girl with pink eyes.
Either of you two see Laurie?
Just went on the other side of the house. Something's going on there.
Hey, Chuck, here's one of them things you was looking for. The little wonder.
How much? $3.50.
A lot of money, but I got an idea. It's 91.
Let's see. That's $3.50 from him and $45.50 from you. That makes $50, don't it?
No, $1 short.
Darn it. Must have figured wrong. How much you give me for the rest of the stuff in this bag?
$1.
Stop. Yeah, now I got $50, don't I? Know what that means? It means I've got to take AYE back from you.
You wouldn't do a thing like that to me.
Oh, wouldn't I? When I tell a cop where I got most of the money from, he'll change his mind about who's smart and who's dumb.
Say, young fellow, you certainly bunkum me.
Four and a half.
$4.75.
75. Come on, gentlemen. School hasn't been built yet. Gotta get a nice chimney.
$5.
Go for $5. Go on.
And 2 bits.
We can't afford it anymore.
Ain't got nearly enough yet. Not for cold duck with stuffing and that lemon meringue pie.
$6.
Going for $6. Go on.
And 2 bits.
Mind your stubborn, Judd. Mr. Kearns is a richer man than you. And I know he likes custard with raspberry syrup.
Oh, let it go.
Ain't nobody going to bed no more?
No, we all dropped out, can't you see?
You got enough, anyone.
Let's get on with it.
Here's the money.
Hold on, you. I ain't said going gone yet.
Well, say it.
Going to Judd Fry for 6 1/4. Going.
Hold on. Did you say we're getting what?
Judd Fry.
How much?
6 1/4.
Well, I don't think that's quite enough for you.
It's more than you got.
Got a saddle. Cost me $30.
Can't fit saddles. Got to be cash.
$30 saddle. Must be worth something to somebody.
I'll give you $10 for it.
Don't be a fool, Kelly. Carry on the loon without a saddle.
Cash?
Right here.
Let's not waste time. How high you go?
Higher than you, no matter what.
Okay, well, there's all this $10. Two, just give me.
$10. Go on.
$10 and 2 bits.
Kelly!
Most of you boys know my horse. Done. She's a counterfeit. Nice horse, doing a well pull.
Don't sell gun, Curly, it ain't worth it.
Look at the pretty body, girl. So, I make 5 bits, get it 5, you know?
Curly, you're crazy, but it's all for the schoolhouse, ain't it? All for educating and learning. Going for 35, going...
Hold on, I ain't finished, Ben. You just put up everything you got in the world, didn't you? Can't beat your clothes, because they ain't worth them. Can't beat your gun, because you need that. Yes, sir, you need that now. So, Ann Hour, I'm just as reckless as going to the plane, I guess. Just as good at getting what I want. Gonna be all I've got in the world. All I saved for 2 years doing farming. All for Lord. Here it is, $42.31.
Anybody want to buy a gun? Bought a brand new one, it's worth it, right?
Please, Cody, please don't sell your gun.
The gaming doctor.
That makes my bet 50 grand, y'all. Anybody going in to hide?
So, go!
What's the matter with you folks? Ain't nobody going to cheer or nothing?
That's right. The farmer has a calendar, sure, friends. Come on, calendar, shake the farmer's hand. I lost a bit, but the bit was fair. Come on, you two shake hands.
Sure, I'll shake hands. No hard feelings, surely.
That's the idea.
Come on, Lars, let's go.
Say, Curly, I want to show you something. Excuse us, Larry. You ever see one of these things?
Just what is that?
Something special. You put it up to your eyes to see pictures.
Curly, go! What are you doing?
Doing nothing much.
Well, then stop looking at those old friends' pictures and ask me for a dance. You brought me to a party, didn't you?
Okay, I'll dance with you, crazy woman. Dance on the metal, come on.
Let's enjoy the party.
Some capers when I was up in Kansas City Mall.
No!
I hear something they call them grinning papers. From
Why, you're gonna do something about it?
Why, you're nothing but a mangy dog, and somebody ought to shoot you. You think so much about being a hard hand. Well, I'll tell you something to rest your brain, Mr. Judge. You ain't a hard hand for me no more. You can just pack up your duds and scoop. When I have better eyes than that, ain't to come on the place again. You hear me? I'll send your stuff any place you see. But don't you as much as set a foot inside the pasture gate, or I'll set the dogs on you.
Said your say. Brought it on yourself. Can't help it. I can't never rest. I told you the way it was, you wouldn't listen.
Annie! Hey, Annie!
Who's that?
It's me, Laurie. Say, have you seen Annie? She's gone again.
Well, could you do something for me? Could you go find Curly and tell him I'm here? I want to see Curly awful bad. I gotta see him.
Then why wouldn't you tell him how to do it, crazy woman?
Curly!
Now you've got a few of that, then I hunt for mine.
Now, what else do you want to do, Curly? If I go, if you ain't crying.
Curly, I'm afraid. Afraid of my life.
Toadstools?
Don't you leave me.
Great wop?
Don't mind me a crying. I can't help it.
Can you?
Oh, I don't know what I'm going to do.
Yeah, I'll try. Follow man can's doing a public. Get away from me, you.
Curly, don't you like me?
Why can't you get away from me? Come away from me.
Curly, you're sitting in the stove!
Great God, I'm hiding. Oh, it's as cold as I'm in the
glass. Wish they'd burn the hole in your pants.
Oh, you do, do you?
You hear me.
Oh, all right. You stand right over there where you are. Now stand over here. You tell me what you want to do.
Well, Jeff's here. He talked wild and he threatened me. I never saw nobody like him. Well, I wish I hadn't done him. There's no telling what he'll do now.
You know you found him, man. That's all there is to it. Ma get to do it out there. I'll stay in the place myself tonight if you find my found him. I quit alone. I must thank you. Well, thank you. How about marrying me?
Gracious, what do I want to marry you for?
Couldn't maybe think of a reason why you might.
Can't think of nothing right now. Hardly.
Oh, Laurie, right, please, man. Please marry me. Don't know what I'm going to do if you don't.
Why, Curly, I'll marry you if you want me to.
On behalf of this man that I have since been married, I gotta be a father, I see that. Quit thinking about me, phone over. Start getting my hands twisted a new way. Well, things is changing right and left. Right and left, through your heart. Act that far in the south. We're making a stay out of this, Kevin Collie. Born in Colorado, Oklahoma. That's what it changes. How to change with it. Bring up a pair of boys. Keep up the things that's going in this crazy country. But now I got to get it open. Run up to 7 years. Oh, I remember the first time I was beside you. Was at the fair. He was riding that great filler at Pusta, and I says to someone, squeeze that skinny little thing with the bag hanging down in the forehead.
I remember. You was riding Bronx that day.
That's right.
And what if we told you?
I'm not fooling.
Guess you jumped out then.
Sure I jumped out.
No, you sure did.
Hey, I can't run out on this shop to hear my voice. Hey, roll it over, roll it over, smack out.
Curly.
Sweat down, yes, goodbye.
Here you go, all the way to Susie.
People say we're all.
man I know who loves you like nothing ever loved Opie. A man who will stick to you all your life, be a regular Darby and Jones. And that's the man for you, Will Parker.
Oh, he! Will I like Will a lot?
He is a fine fellow, strong like an ox, young and handsome.
I love how rad he is.
Of course you do. And you love those clear blue eyes of his, the way his mouth wrinkles up when he smiles.
He loves you!
I love him because it will make my Edowani happy. Goodbye, my baby. I'll show you how we say goodbye in Persia.
That was goodbye!
We have an old song in Persia. It says, one goodbye is never enough. I am glad you will marry such a wonderful man as this Will Parker. You deserve a fine man, and you've got one.
Oh, hello, Will! And how can you say goodbye?
Ah, Will, I want to say goodbye to you too.
Now you know!
I saw the last one. Ah, you were made for each other. Be good to her, Will, and you be good to him. Goodbye, my baby. You don't mind, I'm a friend of the family now.
Did you say you was going?
Yes, I must. Back to the open road, a poor gypsy. Goodbye, my baby. Friend of the family, I show you how to say goodbye in my country. This person, goodbye. Lucky fellow. I wish it was me she was marrying instead of you.
It don't seem to be making a lot of difference.
Oh, well, back to the open road, the lonely gypsy.
Italy!
You ain't gonna think to that old peddler anymore, are you? Of
course not. Never thinking only as he's with me.
Then I ain't never gonna leave your side.
Even if you never go away to pray for nothing, King Charles, once in a while, give me one of the Persian goodbyes.
What? Persian goodbye? Why, that ain't nothing compared to an Oklahoma wolf. Hello, Annie.
Hello, Will!
Scared all night. Scared of death fright. Come on, stop her thoroughly.
Why, just frightened of the third voice of grieving.
He's back. Seen him at Claremore last night. Trump is alone.
It ain't too early, I know.
down and zip it. Speed cop has gone upstairs.
What you gonna do, Pop? Your Curly and Larry shivering? I wish you wouldn't.
Oh, it's a good old-fashioned custom. Never for anybody. You women just keep out of the way. Vamoose!
What are you Curly and
Larry? Stop gabbing about it.
Tonight, please.
Tonight? Why,
Why, you're the judge, ain't you, Andrew?
Yes, that's right.
Well, come now and get it off with.
What did Papa have to do with that girl?
Fiddlesticks, let's do it here and save it in court.
You can't do that, it's breaking the law.
Well, let's not break the law, let's just bend it a little. Come on, Andrew, start the trial.
Andrew, I'm going to protest.
Shut your trap! You can get to buy a fair trial here, but not long enough for this red night. Here's a long and short of it. Now, why's your queen? I mean, why did you do it?
Why did you do it? Because she's been passing a lot of
time. Just a minute. Don't let your palm wobble around your mouth like that. Listen to my question. What happened tonight that made you kill me?
Why you coming with a knife?
And you had to defend yourself, didn't you?
That's right.
Never mind it for the more. The plea of self-defense.
Yeah.
Quiet! Now, so when is all this happening?
I see. Yes. You don't feel funny when I tell your wife you're carrying on with another woman.
I can't help no one.
Maybe not, but you sure feel funny when I tell your wife you are.
Shut up about being feral, Marsh. We ain't gonna let you lock up the boy the way you went, and I ain't gonna let you. So shut up about being feral, Marsh.
Come on, fellas. Let's cool down and chain and curly shirt and be over the horses.
All right. Hey! I didn't mean to hold you the belt up yet.
The verdict's not guilty, is it?
Of course, but I gotta say it.
Well, let's say it. Not guilty!
Yeehaw! Court's adjourned.
Should be, Andrew. Why, anybody? You're never stupid.
We look like he had a misunderstanding, but he explained it fast.
Yeah.
gentlemen, just be grateful you haven't earned it. Both will be in the Rose of Franks tonight. You might have plenty of guns all along. Funny how young people are fascinated by guns. Well, I've been doing other work in the school over the last few weeks apart from this show. And one of the projects the first year was looking at a novel called Carrie's War, dealing with the Second World War. And we invited one of our adult students along, Nancy Ross, to talk to the young people about what life was like in the Second World War, because Nancy had been an ATS officer. And she was telling the youngsters that during the war, the women did all the work and the guns. They took them apart, they greased them, they put them together again. They did everything on the guns except fire them. And she said, now why do you think it was that the women were not allowed to fire the guns? The one wee boy said, they weren't allowed to fire the guns, miss, in case they missed. Well, nobody has missed tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Everything has been bang on target. Through the week I spoke to these young ladies and gentlemen and said that on Friday night I wanted to be so proud that my head would be too big to get on the platform. Well, I'm having a struggle. I'm really very proud of you, ladies and gentlemen. A great deal of work goes into a project like this. This is the biggest project that any school can do. And those of my friends in the front row of education will know this is a prime example of active learning. But behind the scenes, there are a lot of people who contribute a massive amount to the success of a show like Oklahoma. For example, our business manager, Mr. Caldwell, our ticket printing, which is done by the business studies department, our posters done by Mr. McClellan in the art department. The set design and the construction advisor, Mrs. Anderson, and constructed by pupils, Heather Lindsay, Stuart Nichols, Robert Henderson, Brian Jeffrey. The scenery set and painting by David Murray, John Nichols, and Richard McNeil. And the actual construction itself was done by a gentleman called Mr. Simmons, a member of staff. Now you see that very fine house at the back there. Wimpy have already put in a bid for that. Offers over 23,000. Now, Mr. Simmons not only was engaged in building the house and the set and all the rest, he was having a very exciting time on the home front because his baby daughter was born in the middle of all this. So I would like to thank Mr. Simmons not only for constructing the set, but for doing his best to put a stop to the falling school roll situation. Ladies and gentlemen, would you express your appreciation? Doing the sound for us with Mr. Tom Patterson, able to help by a former pupil, Ms. Shona McVeigh, and the lighting, David Shanks. It's a very colourful show, Oklahoma. They're very well dressed. Even the people who have lost their pants are still very well dressed. I'm grateful to our wardrobe mistress, Mrs. Bogle, for that. I was thinking, in fact, it's prize-giving next week, and I'm really needing a suit. And I couldn't make up my mind whether to borrow Harry Watson's or Ali Hackins. Our makeup supervisor, Miss Kelly, our prompt. I don't think she's been too busy this week, but it's been very nice to have her safely there looking after us, Miss Karen Hasty. Mr. John Watson, our stage manager. His crew, David Murray, John Nichols, Brian Jeffrey, Richard McNeil, Robert Henderson, Stuart Nichols. And looking after the many prompts, Heather Lindsay, Debbie Sneddon, and Lee Hamill. Ladies and gentlemen. Very fortunate in this school to have a tremendous support from the Parent, Teacher and Friends Association, who've been very active throughout the year, and particularly over the last few nights. They have been responsible for doing the teas that you enjoyed at the interval. They've also been responsible for doing the raffle, because production like Oklahoma is tremendously expensive and we need all the help we can have. So to the ladies and gentlemen of the PTFA, and to Mrs. Clark, to Mrs. McEchnie, and to the donors of prizes for the raffle, I express my warmest appreciation. fortunate here, from time to time in the course of our school year, to have the services of a group of very distinguished musicians. And they're looking particularly smart tonight with the red roses. This is a nice little gesture, I think, Harry and Christine and Dorothy do, not only for me, but for the orchestra. I've been feeling a little Neil Kinnock, let's say. You know, red hair, a red rose, and on a winning streak. Of making the orchestra honorary members of the PTFA, but the only privilege you get from being a member of the PTFA is playing at Braidhurst. Very grateful to you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for sharing your talents with us. Thank you for giving these young people an opportunity to sing and act with a professional orchestra. Now, of course, the work of a show like Oklahoma doesn't just go on in one week, it goes on for months on end. And the tunes have been drifting all over the school for a good many months now. So we have a core of people who have worked all that time. Choreographer, for example, there's a lot of dancing in Oklahoma, particularly very attractive can-can that we all enjoy, is Admiral McCauley. This is Admiral McCauley. Of course, we have another triumvirate that are very important. I think if we want to invite them up on the stage at this time, Christine Johnson. Sparkling producer, and we're fortunate for many years now we've had Dorothy Adam. She's around somewhere. If that person can relax, that's not going to happen to him. Harry Watson. A good year for Harry Watson because we had a super concert here in February when his composition Renaissance was played for the first time and was later repeated at a concert in the Civic Centre, and I'm very hopeful that in fact next year in a Strathclyde basis it will be performed as part of the Glasgow City of Culture celebrations. He's also had a number of musical events in the school. He's conducted a Lanarkshire Sicilian Orchestra, he's conducted the Canvas Network Choir, and of course he's done this marvellous show. And on top of doing all this, he's actually having a birthday this year. In fact, he's having it tonight. It's that particular birthday when I believe, I'm still to reach it myself. So Harry? Ladies and gentlemen, for being such a super amateur. Shoot that fiddle, please. And to wish you a safe journey home. Good night. Thank you.